This is the latest transfer news. Arsenal are close to completing two signings within a couple of days, and the first one has already been announced. Arsenal have just announced the signing of David Dreyer, and the one for Calafiori is edging very close. Reports from Italy, from Di Marzio, says the deal is already agreed, actually. So let's start with the Calafiori one before we go to the Raya one. Remember, people will say Raya is not a new signing, but he is. You still have to keep your players. Yes, you can buy players, but you don't forget about the ones that you currently have. So if someone like a Saliba signs a new contract today, I basically count that as a new deal. So let's go to the news from Di Marzio in terms of the Calafiori. Riccardo Calafiori is heading to Arsenal. Transfer fee is 50 million euros. So this is 42 million pounds plus the deal for Raya. That will take it to 69 million pounds. So 69 million double deal for a goalkeeper and a defender. If your budget is around 200 million, that is not a problem at all. If your budget is 200 million, I think that is fair enough, especially if Ramsdale is going to leave. You might need a backup goalkeeper and you still need to sort out midfield strike and all that. We still have enough budget to get it done. So for 50 million, that would be an okay deal. 50 million euros for 2 million pounds. That would be a good deal for Calafiori, considering the teams that you have beaten. Because in my mind, I was like, Juventus is definitely a good destination for him. If he wants to stay in Italy, he can just easily move from Bologna to Juventus. Many players have done that in terms of Italian teams. Higuain has played for Napoli and then Juventus. Players like Locatelli, players like Vlahovic, you know, they play for a smaller team in Italy and then they move on to Juventus. A lot of people do that. In Spain, people move on from Bilbao and Betis and go to Barcelona and Real Madrid, from Real Sociedad. So players usually prefer to stay in their country. But for those who don't prefer, and Bologna not wanting to sell to Juventus, that has really helped us. Now, the only thing was, the other team that I was worried about is Leverkusen. Now, I don't think it was one lucky season. People can argue that, but they do have a good project going on there. And their manager as well, Alonso, I think Alonso being there, they can attract a lot of players. And a player like Calafiori can be like, you know what, you know, Leverkusen, they're in the Champions League now. They've just won the league. Why not? I can also go there. If he loves Germany as a country and loves Leverkusen as a team and loves the project there, he can easily move there. I was not really worried about Chelsea. Seems like he's rejected Chelsea, which could be great. Now, people will be worried about Chelsea coming in last minute, but I'm not worried at all. I mean, Champions League, Conference League, you know, all that. There's a lot of things going on for going the right way for us. The time Mudrik joined Chelsea, Arsenal were not in the Champions League. So a lot of things have changed even since then. Now we are Champions League team 2 seasons in a row. We've competed for the league 2 seasons in a row. We've been there until the final day of the season. So things have changed. If Chelsea come in right now and say, yeah, we have 120 million for Calafiori and that is the way they hijack it, there's nothing you can do about that. You let them have him because you're not going to spend that crazy money for a deal like that. You know, if you feel like it's not worth that, absolutely fine. But in terms of 50 million euros, I think he's definitely going to join us. We already had that he's agreed personal terms. In terms of wages, we'll talk about it in a different video, but it's not going to be too expensive. I think it's very affordable. So really, really happy to be getting this player. And it's looking like the deal is very, very close to be done. So that was from Di Marzio. This was from Mail Sport last night. Also now attempting to push through a deal for Riccardo Calafiori before their preseason tour of the USA begins. So today is 4th of July. I think we are going to have him there before, even if he's going for a 2-week holiday or something, because he was just at the Euros. By the time the team travels to USA around the 18th, 19th there, I think he'll be part of the team and he'll be ready to, you know, maybe take the left-back position. Left-back position for us, no one has really owned that position yet over the last actually, a lot of years, I'd say. Timber came in, he got injured. Tomiyasu has never really, you know, taken that left-back spot. Like totally, Zinchenko hasn't really done it. He looked like he had after the first season. A player like Tierney looked like he had for a couple of seasons, but after came in and everything changed for him. So yeah, we've never really had someone playing at that left back position for 3-4 years. Like Gabriel has been playing this particular position for 4 years. Saliba has now been playing, that was his second season. Ben White has been playing for us 3 seasons in a row, second season as a right back, just done, is heading into the 3rd season as a right back. We've never really had someone at Arsenal playing left back for, you know, 3, 4, 5 years consecutively. We always make changes. They always sign players. Players always get injured. So Calafiori could come in and make that position his own. He's a very good player. He can create chances. He can overlap. He can invert. He's comfortable in the ball. He can defend. He can attack. So he wouldn't really take too much time settling into that. The other question is, how long will he take to settle into England and the culture and all that? He's still a very, very young player. I believe he still has time and he's going to adapt very easily. The playing style, the way the driving runs he loves making, and the fact that he's comfortable in the ball and he loves keeping possession, I think that will make him very comfortable at Arsenal. So it's not like signing someone, you know, who's coming from a totally different like style of play. No, he's used to playing that way. I've seen him playing that way for Italy, and you could see that they really missed him when he missed that Switzerland game. He's very comfortable in the ball. He's basically the ball playing defender from the back. So I'm looking at him, Gabriel Saliba, Benoit. That is a very, very solid defense. Last season, we were able to keep 18 clean sheets with Gabriel Saliba, Benoit playing every game. But at left back, we weren't really consistent at all. Zinchenko's playing a couple of games, and then it was Tomiyasu a couple of games, and then Timber started the season at left back. Kivio played that position. So we were able to keep those 18 clean sheets with making a lot of changes at left back, with switching our goalkeeper after the season had started, with Ben White. Sometimes I think he got injured for the, I think this season he missed a couple of games for the first time in his Arsenal career. We had to play someone there. We brought in Cedric from the bench a couple of times. So the fact that we're able to keep all those clean sheets with Gabriel Saliba and Ben White 90% of the time, being the only consistent defenders and always playing every game, that was very impressive. And on top of that, Partey started as our right back in the season, and Saliba and Ben White were the center back. So that was very good. So now imagine adding this player, and then you have a solid back four, and then you know you can rotate with players with like Tomiyasu and Timber. I've seen a lot of people saying Timber now, can we move him to midfield? What happens to Timber? What happens to Tomiyasu? We've been talking about squad depth. That is what you wanted, squad depth. So it doesn't necessarily mean if Calafiori comes in, Saliba is going to Real Madrid, I've also heard that, or Gabriel is going to Saudi Arabia. No, squad depth. I'm hearing Man City, I want to sign another defender. Can I remember the guy? I think it's disappeared. I can't remember. I'm focused on Arsenal more than any other team. But I think one's still like targeting a defender for like 40, 50 million or something like that. They already have Ake is going to be there. They already have Akanji. They already have Walker, Stones, Diaz, and many others. Vardiol on top of that. You need squad. It doesn't necessarily mean that because Calafiori is coming in, Timber is now going to move into midfield or anything like that. No, you have squad depth. You have all eight of those defenders at the moment. Before anyone leaves, we have eight defenders. You can have Zinchenko and Calafiori at left back. You have Gabriel and Kivio as the center backs on the left side. You have Saliba and Timber on the right side. And then you have Ben White and Tomiyasu. So that's a solid defense. Now, even if one of the player leaves, you still have seven defenders, and that doesn't necessarily mean that one has to go, like Saliba has to go to Real Madrid or Gabriel has to go to Saudi Arabia because you signed someone. No, that is squad depth. We need to add to a squad depth, and Calafiori will do that. Agent Jorginho. Thank you, Agent Jorginho. Seems like he's done his work in terms of convincing Calafiori to join Arsenal. I think this is a good move for him. I think he'll fit in very, very well into Arteta's system. It allows players who win duels and, you know, make interceptions and tackles and defend well. Someone said Arteta is obsessed with defenders. Listen, as long as it is working and we're keeping clean sheets, absolutely no problem. I'm happy with that. As long as we're keeping clean sheets, if you were able to keep those clean sheets less than close to 20, with a settled defense, and Calafiori on top of that, and Timber on top of that, and Tomiyasu on top of that, three players we didn't have last season, because Timber we pretty much didn't have him last season, and Tomiyasu was out for almost 70% of it. That is absolutely huge. So Calafiori, this deal is getting very close. Let's hope it gets settled very soon. Really, really happy with that. So next up, let's get the latest on David Raya. Arsenal have just announced the signing of David Raya. This is what they've had to say about this. So David Raya signed a new long-term contract with the club to complete his permanent move from Brentford. The 28-year-old goalkeeper spent last season with us on loan and was an integral part of the success we enjoyed and history we made. He made 41 appearances in all competitions, keeping 20 clean sheets. So that is in all competitions. I think in the league we kept 18. All competitions could be 20. They also go on to say he earned the 2023, 16 of those were in the Premier League. I was confused. So yeah, David Raya kept 16 clean sheets. I think Ramsdale kept, did he keep two or something? I think he kept two, right? Two on. I confused. I think we kept 18 Premier League clinches, but yeah, we definitely kept a lot. I know Ramsdale did keep a couple as well. Born in Barcelona, Spain, he arrived in England age 16, signing for Blackburn Rovers. He tasted success in Lancashire, gaining his first promotion to the Championship and making 108 senior appearances. Okay, I'm not going to read all of it. It's a bit long, but let's go to this. After joining us on loan last August, David enjoyed a truly impressive campaign. He complemented his strong league form with some fine displays in Europe, most notably in the penalty shootout against Sport in the Champions League round of 16, when he saved two spot kicks to send us into the quarterfinals of the competition for the first time in 14 years. That was really, really good one. David has had this to say about the permanent move. After a year on loan as a Gunner, I can finally say that I'm an Arsenal player for the coming years. I'm excited to see what the future holds, but always living in and enjoying the present. It's a dream come true to be here, and I want to thank you for all the support you have already given me throughout the last year. Again, let me go to what Atta and Edu have had to say about this particular deal. Edu said, we are so happy to have completed the deal to sign David from Brentford. He had a beautiful first season with us, winning the Premier League Golden Glove. He is a talented international, great professional, and a popular figure at the club. We benefited from all of this last season during his loan with us. David's signing is another strong example of our recruitment strategy in action as we continue to build a team that will challenge for major trophies. Atta had this to say, David showed us last season that what an important player he is for us. So we are delighted he is now officially our player. He is big presence in our dressing room, and we are really pleased to keep working with him. We know he will take the strong foundations he put in place last season and build on them in the years to come, and that he will enjoy more success with us. We have a very talented group of goalkeepers, and I love to see connections like the one I see in our goalkeeping unit. The transfer is subject to completion of regulatory processes. So that's it. David Raya has now become the first official signing. He will count as the first official signing because he wasn't our player yet. He was heading to Brentford. So that will count as our first official signing for the 2024-2025 season. And then hopefully that will quickly be followed by Kala Fiori. So well done to David Raya. I think he had a decent season last season. I think I gave him something like an 8 out of 10. He rarely had like bad games or anything like that. So you can count a couple of mistakes, yes, like the one against FC Porto away from home. I don't even necessarily think that was a huge mistake. Maybe stepped out of the line too early or whatever, or too far of his line. But the second leg, he did his job and saved the penalties and helped us go through. And then goalkeepers will make mistakes, but I think in terms of the style of football that we play, is very good. People will also say, you know, it's Arsenal's defense that is good, not really Raya. No, there's a lot. Even if he doesn't make the save, there's a lot. The communication between him and the rest of the defenders, I think the defenders feel very comfortable and Raya is behind them and has the ball. He's very good on the ball. So the defenders feel like, okay, David Raya can do the job for us. Absolutely no problem. Like, no one panics. Like, if you have a goalkeeper like Petr Cech, who is not comfortable on the ball, he would panic. But with Raya there, players do not panic at all. Players feel like, listen, David Raya is comfortable on the ball. He can pick out a pass. I'm confident in him. We don't have to panic. And another thing that I felt he did very well for us last season was the aerial, the catching of the aerial balls and all that, the corners and the freaks. There's a lot of games like Man City, United, like the last few minutes when we were leading, that there was a lot of crosses and David Raya would deal well with them and, you know, take pressure away from us. I think he did very, very well, David Raya. So congratulations to him. He's now officially an Arsenal player. We now don't have any loan players, right? Yeah, it was only David Raya. I've never really been a team to get players on loan, but this one is, this was one of the few that we did, and it worked for us, and we've now made it permanent for 27 million. That's a lot of money. So it's actually still cheaper than Ramsdale, which is very interesting. But congratulations to David Raya, is our first official signing, and we're now waiting for Kala Fiori to be our second official signing for the transfer window. The Matias reported that the deal is basically done. He's heading to Arsenal, transfer fee of 50 million euros, which is 42 million pounds plus the 27 million. That makes it a 69 million double deal for center back, stroke left back, and our number one goalkeeper for next season. Let me know what you make about all that. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch up with you guys on the next one.